Hi, I'm David Weck. Today I'm going to teach you how we perform goblet squats using the BOSU Elite. It's all about the resistance and compression that creates these directional forces that enhance our adductors for flexion and extension. They are powerful flexors and extensors, not just adductors, and we're able to harness the full power of our hips, posterior musculature, balance through the balls of the feet, performing this exercise, and you get immediate carryover effect. So I'll show you some of the exercises we do immediately after doing these compression goblet squats. I set up with my feet turned out 45 degrees. That's just turned out what's comfortable. Knees are going wide, and I begin to compress, squeezing in and down on the dome with the fourth and fifth metatarsals, squeezing the glutes, and I pull myself down, matching the angle of my spine with my shins. The weight helps me come lower and keep the compression and balances the hip flexors with the hip extensors. So I'm just gonna perform a few repetitions, squeezing in and then firing the glutes on the way up, never losing that compression force. I'm really working to compress. It's slow and controlled, never losing that compressive effort, and right there. Now, immediately after that exercise, you're gonna feel light and you're gonna feel the hip flexors and hip extensors easy to balance through the balls of the feet. Here's an exercise that we'll perform immediately afterward. So I'm gonna set up in a wide lunge. I'm gonna hold the kettlebell with the hand pronated. My head is right over this foot, and then I switch, and I switch. Switching that movement, so you can see here, it's balls of the feet, spine and shins are equal, and I'm getting full power of the haunch as I do that, alternating sides, boom, and boom, and that compression squat, using the weight, sets it up that my body just moves better on the ground. So that's our compression goblet squat using the BOSU Elite.